I'm hosting the first ever Roomie Singing Championship where 8 people battle it out with their voices. They think they're just competing for the glory, but what they don't know is that they're actually competing for $10,000. We received hundreds and hundreds of auditions that my team narrowed down to 8 contenders. They will be battling it out 1v1 in a tournament-style elimination game. The last singer standing wins $10,000, which, remember, they have no idea about. The judges are me, Joel from Roomie Official, Tristan Paredes, one of the top YouTube vocal coaches, and Daniel Thrasher, YouTube musician and comedian.
All right, James, it's about to happen. Your first performance, your first duel.
Yeah.
How do you feel? You nervous?
Yeah.
Are you pumped?
Yeah, nervous but pumped, yeah.
You're gonna beat Jonas's contender for yourself, but also a bit for me, you know?
Oh, okay.
I need you to beat Alicia so that we can know once and for all that I'm better than August at hyping.
Well, I'm hyped. I'm hyped now. Slightly concerned, but hyped.
Yeah.
So we have Alicia and James. How are you guys doing, by the way?
Good. Nervous.
Nothing to be scared of, but, you know, do your very best. So, James, I hear you've been on one of our competitors' shows. What show was that?
Oh, God, yeah. I was on The Voice this year. I got really ill, like, 2 weeks before the rehearsal, which we did. Then I was like, I hope we get a day of filming that's, like, a few weeks from now. And we got the first day of filming, and I just remember in the beginning of the song, my voice went, in the second half, I tried to oversing in terms of, like, compensating because I knew I did bad in the first half. And it looked like I was competing against my duet, like, the person I was singing with. We're looking at each other being like, what are you doing? This is not what we practiced. And it was just like...
Oh, dang. So we're moving on to Alicia. So you have a weird struggle as well regarding your feet, right?
I like hit stuff a lot, like at least once a week, and I fall just by walking.
So would that be a problem? For example, if you start touring more, you're on stage a lot. Would you fall a lot on stage, do you think?
I think that's why chairs were invented. So I'll sit mostly.
Okay, so you're going to sit on stage. Okay, so we want to get started with hearing you guys singing. No, wait. There's a non-musical challenge before you start. You guys are ready for this?
Sure.
This is another thing the contestants don't know about. Before every performance, they face a short minigame. The winner of the minigame gets to choose whether they or their opponent sings first. However, the loser also faces a penalty. You guys need to go get something old, something yellow, and something gross in your flat starting now, and first person to get him wins.
Okay.
Gross. Can I unplug this? Oh, that's yellow. Right.
Okay, trust. Got it.
You got it? Yeah. All of them?
Yes.
Oh, damn. Okay.
Ah, Christ.
Okay, Alicia.
Never mind, I think I've lost.
Yellow, okay. Sponge, mm-hmm. Washing.
Oh. Very nice.
Gross, trash from stuff that my sister just finished eating. Old, I got it's this okay, vintage okay. From a thrift shop 3 years ago.
Yeah.
So it's probably older than 3 years.
Well done. Okay, James, so you will actually get a drawback for your audition because of this. You can either put your head under the tap and get your whole head wet before you sing, or you can choose to, during the whole verse of your song, do this thing. And have it be...
Yeah, I'll definitely take the water.
Okay.
Yeah, that's safer.
That's excellent. And Alicia, you decide who starts and who goes second because you won the competition.
He starts.
Okay, I'm going to go and
okay,
soak
James.
Up.
Parta, would you have chosen the water?
Proficient. It's proficient, yes. Okay, we're ready when you are.
Yes, I do. I believe that one day I will be where I was, right there, right next to you. And it's hard. The days just seem so dark. The moon and the stars and nothing without you. You told me not to cry when you were gone. But the feeling's overwhelming. It's much too strong next to you.
That was great.
Oh,
well
was
done.
Awesome.
Well done. We had a little bit of audio dropouts, but I think it's definitely usable. We can definitely judge you from that. Okay, Alicia, we're going to move on to your performance.
Loving you the way I do, it hurts.
Hold tight and sing along. I'm all right, but I could be wrong, baby. I know you remember me. 5'3" in the back of the library. Come on, you could at least try to look at me. I see you're giving me shivers.
Well done. Great stuff. I don't think that I could take one of you guys to be the better singer. However, I would probably still say that I felt, personally, that James chose a song that showed off his voice a little bit more. Alicia, you sound like you could have chosen maybe a little bit more of a difficult song, and you could have wowed me even more. For me, I'm gonna go with James. How about you guys?
Actually, I feel like that's a pretty decent point. I think that they both had really, really, really nice tones to their voices. There's nothing there I'd really want to change. I feel like it came down to song choice. Yeah, I think I have to go with James, just based off song choice.
I would say both of y'all have like a very unique style to each of your voices. I think it's really interesting, but I agree with the song choice.
Very
so
nice.
I would go James and this.
Excellent, both of you. Alicia, you're amazing.
So
don't feel discouraged. If this video does well, we will do more of them. I'm pretty sure you could potentially qualify for the next one because you sound amazing. So thank you so much. Okay, same to you, James. Great one. We will see you in the semifinals.
Tell me, how did it go?
It was surreal, but thankfully I did. Get through to the next round. I did feel bad though, because it just doesn't feel nice like kicking somebody out. Do you know what I mean?
Yes, but it's sad what happened to Alicia, but it's epic what happened to August.
Epic.
Hello.
Are you feeling pumped?
I'm not sure if it's adrenaline or fear, but I think it might be both.
I just want to wish you good luck. I think it's going to go really well.
Oh, I hope so.
You can do this?
I got my flag ready.
Oh, nice.
You're about to face off with Sonny. Have you talked to her yet?
A little bit. My phone's been kind of buggy, so I haven't gotten to talk to everyone that much.
So you wouldn't feel too bad if you absolutely annihilated her then?
I mean...
Welcome, welcome, Matthew and Sonny. So, Matthew, I heard about a so-called a stinky thing that happened to you once.
So, when I was younger, me and a few friends were hanging out in the woods. We're having a good time, and all of a sudden, some dude's like, hey, skunk carcass. And I was like, oh, that's crazy. And then he proceeded to then throw it towards me, and I was like, that's not a thing that people do. And then it hit me, and I was covered in skunk, and it was just the worst thing that's ever happened to me in my entire life.
Okay, it also says here, Sonny, you have eaten a... yak pee pee. What does that mean? I don't get it. Why did you eat it?
So I went to China when I was like 10 or something. We got to this one place and they were serving yak thing. And I got dead and I was the only one at the bottle. So it didn't taste that bad. That was the scary part.
Okay, I have a riddle for you guys, and the first person to say the correct answer will be the winner. David's father has three sons, Snap, Crackle, and...
David,
that's it. You got it. So, Sonny, your drawback will be you have to spin around continuously during the full chorus of your song. Matthew, you decide who starts.
I would like to start.
Okay.
One more kiss can be the best thing. One more lie could be the worst. In my head, there's only you now. This world falls on. You love me, but you don't know who. Don't let me go.
Nice, very nicely done. So, Sonny, how are you feeling? You ready to do your thing? Well, you gotta rotate during the chorus as well. Something to think about.
Oh, yeah.
I feel something.
Come on, vibrato.
Well done. Big applause. I think we've lost Matthew. We gotta keep things going. Let's actually talk about things anyway with just Sonny here.
Sure. Is it Sonny or Sonny?
Sonny.
Sonny, gotcha. Okay. I like that choice of song. I liked the spin of your voice was really nice. And I think it felt very free. I was jamming to that song that Matthew chose. I don't know if it was because he's so tall and he's sitting in a car, but it did feel a little bit more tense. So I feel like for those reasons, I think Sonny is my preferred candidate this time around.
I would also have to go with Sunny. I really liked all of the control and range that Sunny showed us. Her vibrato was really nice. And I think that Matthew's, the tone of his voice was really, really nice. I just felt like as he started to go up in pitch, he started to lose some control over his voice.
I have to agree with everyone else. Matthew was great, but me and Matthew have similar problems in some ways where we can both sing a little bit heavy. He didn't thin out when he went up in range. Like, he reminded me of myself on some days. And Sunny was really functional, really controlled throughout. I'm gonna have to go with Sunny, so thank you. We will see you in the semi-finals. Congratulations.
Congrats.
Thank you.
And guys, we're gonna link to all the contestants' social medias in the description if you like someone.
Meanwhile, in the lounge.
Jonas has glasses.
True.
And he's ugly.
Debatable.
I never met someone as ugly as him.
Oh, I can see that.
But it doesn't matter. 'Cause he's also a really bad friend.
How's it going?
Hi. It's going good. How's it going with
yeah.
you?
Yeah. Are you pumped? Are you warmed up?
So
are you ready
pumped.
To go?
You're gonna face off against Soha.
Yes.
I'm gonna need you to go in there and I'm gonna need you to absolutely destroy her.
Okay.
We want to beat Jonas. We're going to show him who rules, right?
All right.
She's a reasonably nice girl, I'm sure, but it's not about her, really. It's about August. Because let's be real, August is a bit of a sleazeball, and I want to beat him.
Okay, you have to win. We got to win.
I think you're going to ace this. I'm rooting for you. Good luck.
If I have to dunk my head in water, I don't know about that.
Well, you never know.
True.
You never
I
know.
Saw that, and I was like, what? I did my makeup for that? Like.
Hello, Clarissa and Zoha.
Hello.
Okay, Clarissa, in my notes here, it says that you struggle to talk about your feelings. So I was thinking, can you tell us a little bit about your feelings around being in this competition? How does it make you feel?
Okay, well, I feel very excited. So excited. I just took a huge dump before this. But I'm also very nervous. Or actually, maybe it was the nerves that made me do that. But I'm very happy to be here. I'm excited for this opportunity. So thank you.
That's awesome. You didn't struggle to talk about that at all. And Zoha, is that how you say it?
Yeah, you got it.
You will start. And the game we're going to be playing is song title chain. One person names a song title. The next person then has to name a song title that starts on the same letter that the last song title ended on. If you take too long to answer, you lose. And if you don't know the artist for the song you pick, you lose. Let's get started. Okay, Zoha.
Bohemian Rhapsody by Queen.
You Gotta Be by Desiree.
Electric Love by Borns.
So another E. Everything I Wanted by Billie Eilish.
Ooh.
Dark Red by Steve Lacy.
Yep, that's real.
Doo Wop by Lauryn Hill.
P.
Oh my God, no. What was his name?
No, what was his name?
Three. I'm sorry. The time is up. Zoha, you will have to pinch your nose throughout the duration of your verse. That is a hard one. You can still wow us for the chorus. Clarissa, since you won, you will also get to choose who starts. Who will start?
You know what? I'll start.
Okay, Clarissa, the stage is yours.
Did a full 180, crazy, thinking about the way I was. Did the heartbreak change me? Maybe, but look at where I ended up. So, you don't wanna see me dancing with somebody. Hey. You wanna believe that anything can stop me.
Well done, Clarissa, everybody. Zoha, your turn to take the stage.
Be your answer, 'cause you're so handsome, but I'm in love with my future, and you don't know her. Ooh.
Whoa, very nice. Well done, Zoha.
Well, I like them both. And actually, Zoha's like nose challenge actually was pretty significant. significant in that because Billie Eilish, she does it a lot in a lot of places. I noticed that there was a few places where it would have otherwise softened up because it would be coming out of your nose a little bit, but it had to come out of your mouth. So it turned into this like sound. But you did a very good job with it in general. Like, I don't know. There's no other way to approach that, to be completely honest with you. Clarissa had a very, very energetic and charismatic performance with like lots of dynamic range. And I think I have to go with Clarissa.
Okay, I guess it's my turn. So I really like both performances as well. I think that my feeling was that Clarissa was a little bit more nervous and maybe did like a couple mistakes along the way there. So it's a very, very close. It's like a 51-49%. I think I'm going to have to go with Zohar for this one. So Daniel is the split vote.
Oh God. Because it is a singing competition, I will gravitate towards the one that I would more likely listen to on the radio while I'm taking a poop. And so
we have a theme.
For that, I will go with Zohar in this particular instance.
Thank you.
Then that is it. Clarissa, great job. You are amazing. Don't for a second let anyone get you down, even though Daniel messed you up this time. Daniel did it. Oh my God. Bye bye, Zohar. We will see you in the semi-finals. Before we continue, I want to give a big thanks to today's sponsor, House Party, who just came out with their new karaoke update. Oh wow, the ad is relevant to the video. House Party is a group video chat app that actually has activities to do with the people you're in the call with, and it's really fun. And yes, the newest one is a karaoke app. You can sing with your friends. They have over 10,000 songs. You'll never be able to sing all the songs. There's so many. They also have a bunch of other games like music trivia and Uno and just a bunch of really fun things you can play with your friends while you're on camera on your phones together. It's like lockdown what? I didn't even notice. I was on the House Party app having fun. I'm pretty blown away that no one has done it this well before because it's amazing. If you want to practice for the next Roomie Singing Championship, you can use the karaoke app on your own as well, but I recommend singing with friends. Here's me and my editor singing just a few minutes ago.
I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more.
Hey! I can wholeheartedly recommend this app. It's so much fun. You can download it with my link in the description to your mobile or to your PC. Please support them. They're the reason I can make an expensive video like this. Thanks to House Party for sponsoring this video. Let's continue with the competition.
What happened?
I don't know. I was pretty confident that I was going to win. They said a lot of good things about my performance, but I think it was just by a smidge.
To be honest with you, I wonder if August paid off the judges. I'm just going to put it out there.
I'm really happy. You showed Jonas.
Sorry. Let me interrupt.
Okay.
What the f***?
You
eliminated my precious contestant?
Yes.
I'm sorry, Jonas. You gotta do what you gotta do in these. Never. Jonas, you just gotta join my side, bro. You just gotta join my side.
Yeah, whatever. I'm sure you're a great person. Jake.
How's it going?
First match coming up.
You're gonna beat Jonas' candidate. That's what's most important to me, that you just roast Jonas as much as you can.
I'm pumped for this. I'm really stoked, dude.
I'm nervous, man. I don't know what's gonna happen. My internet went out like 30 minutes before the call, but it came back right before, so.
Well, if you got through that stress, you can get through this.
I'm gonna just wish you best of luck say that I'm rooting for you.
All right, buddy, thank you.
Welcome, James and Jake. Please turn on your video.
Hey.
What up, Jake? What's up, James? Hey. This audition is the Battle of the Beards edition. It's not even an audition. This is a face-off, guys. Which of you guys feel like you have the best beard?
I gotta say, I think he actually does, but I like mine. Mine's just very blonde.
It does look good, though. You both look really manly. Nothing like me and Daniel and Tristan.
Can we even grow beards?
No, I can't, dude. I've tried.
I can't. Okay, this is embarrassing. They should be judging us. They got the beards. Yeah. Anyway, so before we get started, we are going to do a little bit of a non-musical challenge that might give you a perk or a disadvantage. This is one of my favorites. You guys are going to try to do as many push-ups as you possibly can. And you will not know how many push-ups the other person did. So it's kind of like a little bit of a mind game as well. I'm going to go ahead and move Jake out and James will start with the push-ups and then we'll switch you guys around, okay?
Should I go or what?
Yeah, go.
Yeah, count out loud.
One.
One.
Two. Three. Four.
17. 18, 19, 20. Boys, that's it.
That's it. 20. Well done. I don't think I could have done that. Very nice.
I want to do them next time.
Sup, Jake? Time for your push-ups, man. You ready to put your phone on the floor and do push-ups as many as you can do, or as many as you think will be more than what James did?
I'm just going to go for as many as I can do, so.
Okay. It might impact your singing if you're tired. I'm just saying. So.
No. I won't be tired.
Okay.
One. Two, three, 20, 21.
Guys, I think he's done push-ups 22. Before.
This is his second round today.
26. 27.
Going a little bit shallow there. A little bit deeper,
29.
Please.
29.
Yes, that's what we're talking about.
Say a little bit deeper.
31.
Mm-hmm.
32.
32. Big applause. Yeah. I'm going to move James back in. James, you did 20 push-ups. Jake, you did 32.
Kristen and I did like 1,000 push-ups, by the way, just while we were waiting.
Right before this.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, just right before.
Yeah, you guys did. Yeah, I ate some ice cream. Of course. Sorry to say this, James, but you're going to have to sing your song without the backing track. Jake, you choose. Do you want to start or do you want James to start?
I'll go second.
Interesting. That's an interesting tactic. We will have a listen to James singing without any backing track. You can start whenever.
1, 2, 3, 4. I was so high, I did not recognize the fire burning in her eyes, the chaos that controlled my mind. Whoa, this love has taken its toll on me. She said goodbye. No, I won't say goodbye anymore. Whoa, whoa.
Ooh. Ooh. Applause. Very well done, James. We're going to move on to Jake immediately.
Kingdoms have fallen. Angels be calling. None of that could ever make me leave. Yeah. Every time I look into your eyes, I see it. Yeah. Ooh, who would have thought I'd get you?
Very nice. Well done.
You were very correct about the doing too many push-ups.
I felt a little bit of either nerves or push-ups from both of you, perhaps a mix. I would say for me, Jake, you went for a very soft emotional song, and I sadly think that you being a little bit out of breath impacts a more intimate performance more. I'm 100% that, you know, if I come to you tomorrow and have you sing this, then you would definitely sing it better than you did now. However, you know, we can only judge from this audition. So for me, I have to give it to James. How about you guys?
I think that Jake had a really, really nice tone, actually. Mm-hmm. And I really liked the way that he approached the song in general. I think the biggest thing, probably the push-ups, it's just some of the pitch accuracy wasn't always there. But I gotta give it to James. James had a really, really crazy high rock range and awesome distortion.
Daniel, just for the record, what are your thoughts?
I don't know. It's so different styles. I do feel like James kind of wanted to tackle this like a lion, though. Like, he came out with like just some kind of crazy confidence that maybe set the tone a bit. So I would have leaned a little towards James as well.
This video was hosted by the Roomy Discord server. Make sure to join it if you don't want to miss more competitions like this one. And also, if you just want to be part of the community.
It's great over there.
Bro, I did it, man. Okay, so check this out.
I'm going to move Jonas in here. I have to do it.
Are you taunting? Is that what this disgusting thing is?
Man, I'm pumped that you got through.
Dude, thank you so much, man. I can't even thank you guys enough for this opportunity. I'm dying right now. I'm so pumped. Let's go.
You made it to the semis. Pretty awesome. I'm just gonna wish you good luck. Say hi to James.
Who you gonna beat?
Sunny.
No, August.
Okay. August.
Who you gonna beat?
August. August, I promise.
What's up, James and Sonny? Turn on your cameras, please.
Bonsoir.
Ah, turned it off instead.
Yo. Nice to see you guys. Welcome to the semifinal.
Good. That was such a weird game.
Just destroy your voice as fast as possible, you guys.
That's a challenge. Just get yourself a nodule.
We're all getting delirious now.
I want
because we're all getting delirious.
Yeah, totally. Yeah.
I'm too tired to even...
What time is it in Australia?
5:30.
Damn.
What?
That's an applause for me, just that. Oh, 5:30. Wow.
Jeez.
That's going to impact your voice a little bit.
I mean, I don't know about you, but I'm tired and it's 8:30 p.m. So,
yeah. We're all the same time.
It's noon where I'm at and I'm ready for bed.
Everyone's just whining, but Sonny's the only one who's going through actual struggle here. We're going to have another little non-musical challenge for you guys. Okay, Sonny. You're going to tell us your best joke in 30 seconds, starting now.
Why did the chicken cross the road?
Why?
Because he was trying to get away from the other chicken because he was trying to social distance.
I'm gonna hear that a golf clap. That's good. Yeah, that's good. And you had like seconds to spare. That's good. Okay, congratulations good. On your joke. I hope you're proud of that one. Sonny, I'm gonna move you out and I'm gonna move James in. James, tell us your best joke in 30 seconds. Go.
Why was 6 afraid of 7?
Why?
7, 8, 9, and I'm scared. That's the punchline. I'm scared. I don't know what to do now.
Was there another punchline for that, and you chickened out of the other punchline?
Just because 7, 8, 9, but I added the bit at the end because I felt like I needed to make it clear what my intentions were.
Okay.
They weren't to be funny. They were to let you know I'm scared.
Oh, yeah, that's all. Okay, guys, what joke you feeling like?
I'd say Sunny for this one because just, you know, chicken social distancing. I picture them in masks. It's hard to eat bird seed. It's just a funny image for me.
We're gonna go ahead and actually give this one to Sonny, James. I'm sorry
that's
about this, but
that's completely understandable. Yeah. That's completely understandable.
So a judge, that would probably be me, will, James, mute your performance at some point. We will not get to do the entire thing, so we will cut you off in proper Simon Cowell vibe. So you'll have to front load with your talents because
you better sound good. You better sound good from the jump.
You better sound good, yes. Sonny, you also decide who starts.
Hold on, there's a scale in my way.
There's a what? A scale. I hate when there's scales in my way. Get rid of it.
Is it a C major scale?
Oh, music joke.
Now we know why you run the comedy channel. So, Sonny, who starts?
I think I'll start.
You'll start. Okay.
Stars, but they always get it wrong, and I feel stupid when I pray. So why am I praying anyway? If nobody's listening, anyone, please send me anyone. Lord, is there anyone? 'Cause I need someone. Oh.
Big applause. Good job, Sonny. Super nice. Well done. We will move on immediately to James's performance.
We don't talk anymore. No, we don't talk anymore.
Dang,
no, we don't talk anymore like we used to do. And we don't love anymore. No, I was all of it for. Oh, we don't talk anymore like we used to do. And I just heard you found the one you've been looking for. I wish I would have known that it wasn't me.
He has been muted, and also he froze anyway. Did I freeze?
You froze, Joel. He was fine.
Did I mute
Joel,
him?
Joel, you're disqualified.
Am I disqualified? No. Sonny, how could you do this to me? Did I succeed in muting him,
enough.
Though?
No, you did not. I don't think you succeeded.
Oh,
in
my
either,
God.
Bro.
Well, I didn't hear.
But you did cut him off early, though.
Okay. To be honest with you, I think the most critical part on that song it starts with, so you were kind of lucky with that.
For me, I think the pre-chorus was
No, you're right. You're right. Oh. I didn't hear that. Yeah, I didn't hear the pre-chorus, and I'm not going to listen to you now because I'd be cheating. Okay. You just like yell it at me. I'm just like, oh, I'm taking off my headphones and just, yeah. This is a difficult one. I gotta say.
You pick, Joel.
I want Tristan to start, I think. Tristan.
Yeah, sure. These decisions are getting much, much harder. It starts to get more and more subjective because, James, I feel like your voice is perfectly suited to that song. And I could just imagine your voice on the radio singing a number of different
songs. I really like that. Thank you.
Yeah, you sound awesome, dude. And Sonny just showed like that was a really good dramatic song. And there's just tons of really awesome stuff going on everywhere. I think I will have to go with Sonny on this one.
Daniel.
So I will say it's two different kind of voices too. I feel like Sonny has some kind of like musical theater background. Is that true or no?
Yeah, it is true.
With James, it's just more of like a studio kind of vibe. I think right now I'm going to lean towards James. Just I know how technically difficult that joint is. Man, he's navigating that Passaggio like it's a racetrack.
It's so ironic to get a voice crack when talking about navigating Passaggios. I love that. I am struggling. That's why I took both of you guys first because I was hoping you guys would choose it for me. But I need to choose someone. I think from what I've heard, I need to draw from both of your auditions now because I feel like it's so even in this one. I would love to hear Sonny sing more, but I think that James impressed a little bit more in his first audition. So I'm going to give it to James this time. Sonny, you're amazing. That sounded so great. Thanks for staying up to 5 a.m. or whatever. That's crazy.
Wow.
You're a better person than I am.
I'm going to give you a huge
You have
applause.
Such an amazing voice, Sonny.
Yeah, that was crazy good. I loved it.
Now let's check out what's going on in the lounge again.
He said, bro, you can use my toilet all you want, don't even sweat.
I lost.
Oh no.
Thankfully I got through. The only thing is like Sunny was like really good. And it was just like, oh, this just feels bad.
I'm really proud of you anyway for doing this, getting up in the middle of the freaking night.
I know.
I'm just going to wish you the best of luck with your singing career.
She may hate you forever, but you know, she did make it very far. Sonny, you know, RIP, I respect you, but show's got to go on and August needs to go damn.
Yeah.
That's it, buddy.
That's it. That's it. You're ready. You're ready.
I want you to win.
I will win. Thank you.
You will win.
If you support me, I will win.
Okay, I will support you. Look, here's a supporting high five. Okay.
Okay, so we're now getting in James Sapognaro, I think that's how you say it, and Zoa Faraz. These two are kind of opposites in terms of dynamics.
Oh, yeah.
So this is going to be a really interesting matchup. This round's minigame is called Did You Pay Attention? So far, I've been wearing a bright blue t-shirt. But before letting James and Zoha into the call, I switched that shirt to a new one. If they can't remember the color of the shirt I wore before this, they will get a penalty. Okay, it's time for another challenge that will impact your performance, Zoha.
Oh boy.
So, I just changed my shirt to the It's a Little Bit Pitchy shirt available on the Rumi official Crowdmade store. Link in the description. Very cheap, very nice. Anyway, Zoha, what color was the shirt I was wearing before?
Blue?
That is correct. Congratulations.
God, you two got me scared for a minute. I was like...
You looked like you didn't know what color it was. It was really good. I liked it. James, so right now I am wearing this It's a Little Bit Pitchy shirt. However, do you remember what color the shirt was that I was wearing previously? Because I just changed it.
Dude. Gray?
That is incorrect. I am sorry, James. That is incorrect. It was blue. Zoa got it right. Before the competition, we asked all of the participants to send us the songs they were gonna sing. Since James lost this minigame, we took his background track and pitched it up 6 semitones. If you don't know music theory, that is a lot. That's basically as far away from his original key you can get, meaning that if he sings the original melody, it will either be a lot higher in pitch than he planned or a lot lower in pitch than he planned, both of which will probably not sound that good, unless he surprises us.
And they say, oh my God, I see the way you shine. Take your hand, my dear, and place them both in mine. You know you stopped me dead while I was passing by. Oh, I like your style. Well, you make me wanna cry. Now I beg to see you dance just one more time. And they say, dance for me, dance for me, dance for me, oh. I've never seen anybody do the things you do before. Things you do before.
Nice! Well done, man.
That was hard. That was hard, bro.
Yeah, man, you found it. You found a good key for you and you modified the melody well. I was impressed. Yeah. That was awesome, man. Well done. I would have done way worse on that one. I gotta tell you.
Yeah,
okay.
Me too.
Okay, time for Zoha. All
right, let's go. Let's go.
The single pays my apartment a few times. And fall asleep on the couch. Uh-oh. All I wanted was you. All I wanted was you.
Well done. Yay. Well done. Paramore, huh? That sounded great. Okay, guys. Daniel.
Yes.
You start.
This is hard. In my head right now, it's really split. James had, despite overcoming technical issues and the challenge, showed a lot of musicality and had to do like instantaneous creativity with the challenge and figure out where he was going to do the melody. He found a way to make it musical. And then Zoha was like super supported and like was very pitch accurate. You know, there's a lot of like softness to the voice, but it can also show some strength underneath. So this is a really hard. I have to decide right now.
Ideally, yes. Yeah.
I'm gonna go with Zoha on this one in terms of which one would I pick up and listen to right now. I mean, really though, it's right down the middle. I mean, get away from me. Somebody else talk.
For me, I think that you were both a little bit mismatched with the approaches you had to your song. I felt like you were a little bit soft for the Paramore song, Zoha. I felt like It got a little bit, you know, too aggressive in the Dance Monkey. James, I feel like you have a taste in music where I would have loved to see you hear some, you know, classic rock, or maybe even like something like Imagine Dragons if you want to go poppier.
Oh,
something that could like have shown a little bit more like that. So I feel like song choice was a little bit against you in this one. However, I'm going to lay my vote to James, but I do think that he deserves that one because that was impressive as heck. So big ups.
So I'm on the same page. It's really, really tough because on one hand, James, I was impressed at how he changed the melody, because what I would have done, and I probably would have changed some notes to falsetto, but kept the same melody.
Mm-hmm.
But he just changed the melody in a way that was, it still sounded right.
It sounded musical, yeah. Definitely.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. But I guess on the other hand, I almost feel like the vocals didn't match the track in a sense. Like the hard rock vocals in the soft piano track. Zoha was very, very pitch accurate, like Daniel was saying. I would have liked to hear a little bit more belting, but it still sounded connected and it still sounded musical and balanced and everything. Oh my God, dude, this one is actually really hard. I think I'll have to go with Zoha as well, just based off of that. It is honestly just like, it's a coin flip.
Thanks, James. Well done, Zoha, as well. I'm sorry you didn't get my vote.
No, you're good. What he did was crazy. I like...
Yeah, that was really cool.
What happened? Are you the bearer of good news?
I am.
Yes!
I'm really sorry to have to break it to you.
Yeah.
But she won.
Yeah. No, okay, man.
I hope you feel happy anyway about your participation. You've got great voice. I think you just gotta keep going.
Thank you, man.
Yeah. It's time for the final.
Who am I going against?
James.
Do we know yet?
Rodzi.
Wait, I just did James.
There's two Jameses.
The other James? Yep. I'm going against the other James. That's funny.
Statistically, you have a 50% chance of going all the way.
No, don't say that. I don't like that. I don't like numbers. When numbers come into play, that means like, oh, it's real and it's like intelligent. So that's not me.
You're going to crush him. I'm just saying, you're going to crush him. And most importantly, you're going to crush Jonas.
Of course.
You're the one with my original hope and passion, and I want you to carry it all the way. Can you do that for me, James, please?
I will try it. I'll put my heart and soul into it.
Just know that I believe in you, and it's going to go great.
Thank you, August!
Okay.
For the grand final, there will be no minigame and no penalties. James and Zoha have been through enough challenges. In this final round, all that matters is their performance. So, welcome to the finals. One of you will be crowned Roomy Singing Champion. Tails, Zoha starts. Heads, James starts. I'm gonna do it right now. And we got Tails.
Oh, it's me.
Yep.
Good luck, girl.
Let's get into some performances.
Don't wanna be stone, cold stone. I wish I could mend this, but here's my goodbye. I'm happy for you, know that I am, even if I can't understand it. If happy is hard, if happy is hard, I'm happy for you.
Right.
Yeah.
That was so good. Oh my God. You are both extremely competent singers. I don't know where this will go.
Yeah.
That was your best performance yet. That was incredible. Let's see James's.
I kissed my penny and I threw it in. Afraid I keep my soul. Went down to the river where the water bends. The only place I know how I can see the forest for the tree. So will you wait for me? Will you wait for me? Will you wait for me? My evergreen.
Oh, and that's all I got.
Dude, what?
Man. I hate the position we're in. That was amazing. Man. Oh, Jesus. Oh my God.
Man, y'all are nasty.
Y'all are nasty.
You are beasts. Tristan, yeah. You're the most technical of us. Maybe.
Always me.
Maybe you found something, whatever, technical you can pinpoint.
They're both obviously really, really good. Zoha, I feel like each time I've heard you, you've gotten progressively better and better and better. I don't even understand how you have made that progress in the amount of time. Yeah, your tone was really good. The notes that you hit were awesome. And James, on the other hand, everything that you did was also really, really nice. Like, your falsetto is just one of the best that I've heard. Like, the way that you're able to, like, darken it and fill it out. And then you also got those, like, really twangy high head voice notes, too. You're both really, really, really good. I think I would have to go with... I'm gonna go with James on this one. Zoha, your voice was fantastic. You made tons and tons and tons of really, really good progress, and I can't wait to see what you keep doing going forward. If you just keep going in that direction, you're gonna be really, really amazing.
Daniel, give us your take.
I think both of y'all are dope, and you should do a tour. Just the two of you. That's what I think. The thing is, Zoha, like, I don't know if it's a technical thing, meaning computer side. When you were hitting your belty notes, what happened was the audio that I heard was ducking. So something in the computer, I don't know if I could hear all the overtones that I am sure exist in your belt. So that's what makes this really hard. I'm gonna say this time around, I will lean towards James. However, I want to see Zoha do covers on YouTube. I wanna watch a video and just see what that looks like. Unbridled without like a bandwidth.
I think you're talking for everyone watching this video that we want to hear more Zoha. That it's incredible. I told you guys to go first because I was extremely split because I was like, is there a potential tie here that we could actually go with some kind of tie if I was like, I'm not going to choose one. But it doesn't matter now. So I can just as well split my vote anyway. So James, congratulations on being Rumi Singing Champion 2020, but Woo! Zoha, you are incredible. Thank you so much. We're gonna have a little bit more of a talk to
thank
James.
Thank you guys for having me. I feel really good.
I'm so
Thanks
glad.
For letting me hear your voice, man. Jeez, you're so sick.
Thank you, Zoha. Amazing.
Nice meeting you.
Remember, James has no idea. He just won $10,000. Congratulations, what? James. This is when it gets weird. You are the winner. You are winning a special prize of $10,000.
Get me le sterline!
You won 10,000! What the flying f- You won it all! That's
amazing! Your sound's amazing!
Oh my god! Oh f- You've paid for my final year of uni.
That's awesome, man! Paying college debt! That's what we're talking about. Congratulations, dude.
Oh my days.
Man, it feels so good also to give this money to someone who just was in it for just like being in it. It feels great, man. I'm so happy, man. You're
What? I can't take any of this seriously. What? I saw your video at 3 a.m. and I was like, oh, that would be so cool. And then I busted out this video and I was like, embarrassed because of how shit the editing was. And I was like, oh God, I won't get in. Then yesterday I almost had a f***ing aneurysm because I got that email and I was like, Jesus Christ. Sorry, yeah, this is not going to be monetizable, is it?
Oh my God.
Thanks for being part of this. It's been so fun to just see you just slay it. Even when we cut you off and everything before you got to show off, you got through.
Thank you so much for having me.
Happy to be paying for your uni. Okay, guys, thanks for being part of this. You guys did a great job as judges. And thank you guys for watching. If you want to see more videos like this, please share it around. We want to do more videos with singing competitions and, you know, cash prizes like this and everything. So if the video gets enough traction, we can get another sponsor on board. Maybe even the same sponsor. Download House Party. If they get a lot of downloads, do the karaoke thing, then it'll be easy. It'll be a home run. Okay, guys, subscribe to Daniel and Tristan, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.